this is too easy now because I know exactly what all these are. So I'm going to preemptively crown myself.
Oh, yeah. With that in mind, Henry, what was the first wine?
Okay, so I didn't actually understand the first one.
All right, welcome back to another episode of Wine for the People. If you don't know what we do, we're going to blind taste a bunch of wines here. We're going to tell you what we think they are, how good we think they are, and how much we'd actually spend to purchase a bottle or more. Our partnership with Different Drop is only growing and with great love and respect. They've sorted out these six wines. They've organized a bracket for us, so we're going to figure out what these six wines' theme is. And if you want a discount on any of the wines, jump in the description, head to the Discord channel. We've got the link there and all of the T's and C's that come along with that. And it actually helps out the show. Really, it would be amazing if you could continue the support. And that's one great way to do it is buy wine. You get something, we get something, Different Drop gets something, everybody wins. Now, quick little question. Last week we had a crazy bracket of wines from all over the world. Is there anywhere that you know makes fantastic or interesting wine that you've tried before or that you want to try? So there's an amazing world of wine that doesn't go just beyond France, Italy, Spain, Australia, all of that kind of thing. There is some really obscure countries that make wine that you might be really curious on. So where's the weirdest country you've tried wine or want to try wine? Without too much further ado, let's get into the tasting.
Wine tastings, we're going again. Spittoon's back, my mortal enemy. It's six red wines, I'm wearing a white shirt. What could possibly go wrong?
Fresh, little purple highlights here. Most of that visual cues are really sort of leading me down the path of Grenache. Let's have a look. Dude, yeah, smells like a two. That is incredible.
I have a gut instinct that we're going to be trying to identify the countries of one particular variety. I'm going to go without smelling that it's going to be Pinot Noir, but we'll find out.
Spittoon? Shut up, Lockie. A little bit of olive tapenade, like that slightly more savory characteristic in the red than that juicy, luscious flavor that I'm usually looking for.
Interesting. Interesting. I think it's Pinot. Big fun here. This isn't fine wine, this is fun wine, and I'm all about it. I'd want to pay around about 30 bucks for it, and I'll buy 12.
Very, very good fun. Drink it quickly. Don't bother cellaring this. It's not going to improve. It's just going to be this quality and this like pure jovial energy for a long time. Very, very good stuff. What a way to start a tasting.
Wine number two, similar to wine number one, good clear see-through, but it's got a little bit of a sort of brick tawny hue thing going to it.
Stupidly aromatic and bright and fresh, but the use of whole bunch here is excellent. Very, very delicious.
Okay, cool. A little bit more vibrant, a little bit juicier, which is clearly something that I'm about. So I'm going to be buying more bottles of it. So it's six off the bat for me.
High acid. I almost think this is wine number one from like a different vintage. Very, very, very similar in style.
Tannin profile is just excellent. Little bit more seriousness here. Little bit more layers of flavor, not as like playful and like bright and jovial as the first one. But this is still very good fun. It's just got a little bit more intensity, a little bit more structure to go along with it.
So a little bit of like peaky sweetness of straw. Strawberries in there, so that's why I'm getting the six, not the three, as opposed to the last time out.
30 bucks, 12 bottles, big fan. What a great cracking sort of Aussie-inspired style as well. This is the wine that I want to drink in a sweltering hot shed where we're tasting wine. Save me.
Wine number three, as I was saying, we were getting into a little bit of a brown rim going on here, which usually to me indicates that it's older or it's corked.
Now that's cracker. A little bit of maturation. It's really tasty. The palate weight and shape isn't, kind of funny, isn't what you would expect to be paying money for.
The acidity is just so delicious. It just keeps all of these like shooting, racing flavors of like cranberries just like continuing to go.
Man, oh man, are these all the same variety? Like, is that what's going on here? It's the same shit, man. It's the same wine. Okay, it's another Grenache. It's 32 bucks, and I'll have another six. So I've got a dozen between the two of them. It's a bit of a stitch up because I think I've just bought the same wine twice.
I'm paying like over and above toke odds, but here I really think it's worth it. I'd be dropping around about $45 a bottle and I'll be buying 12, straight 12 so far. We're looking good.
Number four, light dry red.
Slightly brown rim, pretty similar color to the rest. Could be the same thing happening again.
That's phenomenal. That's Premier Cru Burgundy. It's got to be. It's got to be. That is remarkable. 120 bucks and 12.
It's got a little bit of a straw-y finish. Not strawberry, straw, like the thing that horses eat. Hay, even. would be another term for that. Sometimes we straw and hay, we haven't got time.
There is some structure here, some real presence of tannin, which kind of takes away from this idea of a new world wine, and particularly takes away from Australia. And I see too many Australian Pinots with this level of tannin and class and structure.
Stunning wine, absolutely stunning wine. Probably gonna come home with me tonight.
$40 a bottle, and I have 9 of them. I like them slightly more. I'm more of a Pinot guy than a Grenache guy, and as we've just established, this is definitely Pinot, so.
All right, wine number 5, let's have a look. We've got a little bit of a cloudy number here. So maybe a small departure from what we've seen before. All of these wines look to be like squeaky clean and really well handled, really well elevaged.
There's a lot of like briny, like volatile characters, which, you know, I don't necessarily hate. It's definitely a fault, but I don't see, it's definitely a flaw, but I don't think the wine is faulty.
Yum, sick, so cool. It's like a sour raspberry lolly. Really sour, dope, cool, 12.
It's a struggle on the palate. That is a struggle on the palate. It's really interesting though. It's like drinking a sour cherry.
It reminds me of Merlot or something like that. So they're giving me a Merlot vibe and I like it. I don't hate it. I don't love it, but I'll grab 3 bottles. $38, magic number.
Favorite so far, really weird. I think it's natural, some natural reds. And I reckon it's gonna be that magic 38 because as we all know, every natural bottle of wine in the world costs $38.
All right, last wine. Definitely a bit more brown on the way to Brown Town.
Smells like Pinot. God, I'm good. Oh my God. Give me that. It's preemptive to put the crown on, but I think I'll be wearing it soon.
There is a muskiness to it, which comes hand in hand with the like florality, but I just think it reminds me of like a soap shop and in a kind of a bad way.
Yeah, cool. So that's the Natty Pinot to go with the Natty Grenache. It's also going to be $38. And surprisingly, I like the Grenache more. So I'll just have 9 of this one.
Great wine. Parker.
A little bit lean, a little bit thin on the palate. I would have liked to see a little bit more oomph to it. I think this is probably going to be coming at the magic number, 38.
I would probably launch it about 6 bottles.
Yeah, it's really short, really clipped. And just like the flavor just dies really quickly. And all you left is like chewy tannin and like musk sticks.
But I think it's actually Pinot. I think it's a natural Pinot by a producer who's been a little bit liberal with the use of whole bunch, which is actually coming across really appealing in the wine.
So yeah, look, different drop, honestly. Glad that you're on board. Happy to have a new sponsor for the show, but lift your game. That was too easy. I've obviously nailed all of that. So yeah, just try and challenge me a little bit next week. All right, we'll see what the boys do.
Gentlemen.
Yeah.
This as soon as we walked in, I was like, man, this is a daunting lineup. We see red, 6 light reds, and it's like, what's gonna go on here? For the most part, I was pleasantly surprised. I actually very much enjoyed most of this lineup.
I enjoyed them all relatively equally, and there was one that I was just like, yep, buy a dozen of these, but we've kind of ruined this for me because like this is too easy now because I know exactly what all these are. So I'm gonna preemptively crown myself. I know they're our new sponsor, right, but I threw some shots at different drops.
Leave it on, and the moment you get it wrong, take it off. We'll see how long you last with the crown.
All right. Absolutely. Okay, well, with that in mind, Henry, what was the first wine?
Okay, so I didn't actually understand the first one. So it took me a little while to figure out what's going on. So I called this a Gamay when I first tried it.
Cool.
I no longer believe it to be a Gamay, as you will figure out why I don't think it is Gamay later on. But okay. Really enjoyed it. I thought it was natty-ish, so it was $38. I only wanted 3 bottles though.
I went Gamay immediately. Half a dozen, $45.
Early harvested Grenache. Mm. I rolled with 12, of course.
I actually think you're right. It will be Grenache. Let's find out.
Oh, here we go. Lachlan.
Hey! Crown stays on for now.
This is like Trotter.
Pinot Meunier.
Meunier.
Interesting. Yeah. $38, really good fun. Actually, really good value. Like,
and
I think it.
Producer, I am not aware.
So, this is one by Baby.
Crown staying on for me.
I like it. Second one, this is where I was more and more Gamay. So, I had a little bit more of the whole bunch thing, a little bit more stem, which is why the Grenache thing is starting to really fuck me.
I called this one Grenache. I thought it was $32 and I wanted 6 bottles of it.
Well, because I called the first one that same thing, I thought exact same thing, and of course I'm gonna take 12 and of course it's gonna be $30.
Yeah.
I went 9 for 61, although it was still Gamay.
How much is it? 26, wow. A bit cheap, but that's a really good deal.
That is a 10% off that.
That's hot if you jump onto the different drop website.
That's a really good deal.
Beaujolais, Gamay!
Gamay,
what's
gets
up,
it.
Bitches?
Beaujolais for $26.
Yeah, this is maybe the best value Beaujolais you can buy in Australia. I'm sure there's more and more you can get overseas, but like this is so consistent, delicious, and really great value. Number three, loved this.
Yeah.
Loved this. Yeah. Absolute tarvel, baby. I went 50 for 12.
I went 32 for 6. I thought that was the exact same one. I thought that tasted and smelled the exact same to me.
No.
Which is why I'm not wearing the crown. My theory will come in later on. You'll see what my theory is. Give me that shit!
What is this? Cara Sucia. This is Spanish.
It's a rosé wine.
Yeah, so it's a tarvel style. From 100% Cereza? Is that a variety or that's the region?
Yeah.
It must be an obscure Argentinian variety. That's really fucking cool.
Very cool.
That is really fucking cool.
I've never even, doesn't even hit on the radar ever. Like, where this has even come from. This is gnarly. I don't think the good prices are gonna last.
Now this next wine.
Oofed.
Next wine is spinny as.
You reckon it's a spinny boy?
Yeah, this is like epic Pinot, I reckon.
Yeah.
Bad news for you guys. I also called Pinot.
Whoa! Is this where you learn how to decide between Grenache and Pinot?
I said 40 bucks.
Oh, wow. Oh, I would buy multiple dozens of 40 of this.
Yeah, I went 75 and I'm getting a duds.
I went 120.
Oh, let's go!
What is this? This is amazing. This is amazing.
That is a $40 Foothills Pinot Noir.
Foothills? So is it Vic?
Mornington Peninsula.
Wow.
That is ridiculous.
Wow.
Yeah, so
even Mornington.
$40 Pinot.
That is amazing. That is utterly, utterly brilliant. I haven't smelled that quality of Mornington Pinot ever. Like, this is the best Mornington Pinot I've ever had. I haven't had that many, but this is up there.
All right, things started to take a turn for me. This is the...
Oh, yeah, no way.
This is my first dozen of the lineup.
Oh, my God.
I was hoping that would be the case. It needs a bit of context for me to understand and appreciate it. There's a bit of context that I'm missing here, but it smells like cider.
This is where my theory came in, right? This is when I figured out what was going on here.
Yeah.
Because I realized that we were basically just going, like, Grenache and then something that isn't Grenache. Like something that's masquerading as Grenache.
Yeah.
And yeah. I reckon that this is a natty Grenache. It's $38. I wanted 12 of them.
That is definitely not Grenache.
It's got Mazer vibes.
I think Trousseau.
Yeah, if it's Grenache, there is some wacky shit that's happened with that ferment to make it go wacko.
I'm sorry to tell you that you just happen to be wrong.
All right, well, $38, it's fine.
$38, 12.
3 and 38.
33?
Okay, yep, that's probably the right price.
Come on, baby.
That's fucking Lucy Muggo.
Light red Syrah.
Syrah. I wouldn't pick Syrah.
And look, the context makes sense. Like, the reason why you buy Lucy Muggo's wines are a myriad beyond why you would buy any other wine.
Yeah, look, we've had his wines in the show. One time it was epic, one time it was like this. This is literally...
Epic. It's delicious. I don't know what's wrong with you guys. I really like it.
I still bought 3 bottles. I'd still be happy to drink a glass of this at like a natty wine bar, and that's exactly where I'd be bought. And the last one, this was actually my least favorite. I was not into this. Aromatically, I loved it. Aromatically, I loved it.
I don't think I'm right on this. I thought it was natty Pinot.
Yeah, it's got so much herbaceousness that I just don't think it could be Pinot.
$38 and I wanted 12. I really loved it.
Really?
Well, I really loved it.
Interesting.
The yummy.
I wanted a glass and I'd pay $57. Not for the glass, but for the bottle.
$38 for 9.
There you go. Interesting. What the fuck was it?
Natty Pinot, basically.
Cinsault. Again, that checks out.
That is the least reductive Cinsault I've had in a while. So wacky light reds, I think, is the theme of this tasting, surely.
I owe an apologies to different drop our new sponsors here. I told you it was too easy and I figured you out. Turns out I had not.
Yeah, no, that was very challenging. But yeah, what was the theme? And then one Pinot. Okay, so it was the one Pinot, which was like...
And then, wine of week.
Yeah, the best wine, annoyingly. Oh, like, honestly, that tarb was fucking sick, too.
That tarb was incredible, too.
But yeah, it's like Pinot imitators, but like spot the
imposter.
And we did.
One of these is not like the other.
That's got to be line of the week, surely.
Yeah,
that's stunning.
Definitely. 40 bucks.
$40, that's insane.
Anytime one of you guys is like, this is $120 and it's 40, that's wine of the week.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I'm really excited for these brackets now.
Yeah.
Thank you to all the people on Discord that actually suggested that, because that's real, like, this is so much fun.
And thank you for the guys at Different Drops for actually being very intellectual about this. I love it.
Yeah, this is such a challenge.
Until next week. Ciao.
Bye, wine.